we talk about the two square theorem. This concerns prime numbers, you know, the numbers which are only divisible by one and themselves. The question how to write a prime number as the sum of two squares of natural numbers, of positive natural numbers. The easiest example is take the prime number 2, the smallest prime number. You can write this as 1 square plus 1 square. Now let's try the next prime, 3. Well, 1 square plus 1 square, obviously not. 1 square plus 2 square, already too big, so no. Or 5. 1 square plus 2 squared works. Let's do a fourth example, 7. You try 1 squared plus 6. 6 is not a square. 2 squared is 4 plus 3. 3 is not a square. We see it's not possible. And the question is, do there exist natural numbers x and y such that p is x squared plus y squared? We're asking for a simple criterion which for an arbitrary prime number, we know that there are arbitrary large prime numbers, say with 10 million digits, you tell me or I tell you, can be written as the sum of two squares or not. And if the prime number is so large, we cannot try it out like we did with these small primes.
Are we looking here for a formula or like a way to get those squares or just?
No, impossible. That would be great. Nobody knows a formula. You can only decide, if you have good luck, whether it is possible at all. Not a formula which gives you x and y. If you would give me some prime numbers, say you search on the internet for large prime numbers, you give me one and tell, Professor, now tell me yes or no. And then within a second, I would tell you yes or no.
But you won't be able to tell me what those squares are?
Absolutely not. Nobody will be able, not only me. I suggest that we look into the history briefly. Who did this first? This is the famous French mathematician Pierre Fermat, who did other important things, and he liked such easy to formulate problems. And what did he do with these problems? He made tests. He made long tables. So he took, we have here four primes, he took the primes up to 100, the primes up to 1000, wrote down this list and checked by hand case by case. If you do that, we should show such a list. At the first glance, you don't see any pattern. But Fermat finally observed a very, very simple rule. And that's already his theorem, which I write down now. Prime number P is the sum of two squares if and only if we subtract 1 from P, get a nice number, if this number is divisible by 4. That means you can make a very, very simple test. So let's consider small prime, let's say 17. We subtract 1, we get 16. Divisible by 4, it works. And now we check, is it really true? And we see, 17 is 4 times 4, plus 1 times 1, true. Let's consider 23, other nice prime. We subtract 1, get 22, not divisible by 4. So you can try it yourself at home. You will not be able to write it as the sum of two squares. And the remarkable thing is, this is an easy test to subtract and to check whether it's divisible by 4 is very easy. And you can try now on the internet, write down huge prime numbers, subtract 1, try to divide by 4, and you know, here you go, and you will not be able to find x and y. He saw it, and he tested it again and again. We don't know whether he wrote down a proof. He said it's a theorem, but he is famous for this. He likes, when he was convinced that something is true, he probably believed in God and in the order in the world, and he said, if I see this so often, it must be true. So he wrote down theorem, but without proof. And the mathematicians after him wondered about the proof. Very good mathematicians, and could not do it. 100 years later, the Swiss mathematician Euler gave the first proof. A tricky proof, complicated, too complicated for this video. First proof. Then, 50 years later, Gauss gave a completely different proof. 70 years later, Dedekind gave again a completely different proof. So the mathematicians like to give different proofs of the same theorem because of every proof sheds light on the statement. And all these proofs shed different light on the statement. So that's all these proofs are too complicated even to speak about that here. But about 15 years ago, the mathematician Don Zagier from Bonn gave the famous one sentence proof. And that we are going to talk about.
One sentence?
In one sentence, of course you will see, for an ingenious mathematician like Zagier, it can be done in one sentence. For ordinary mathematicians like me, I need already 10 sentences. And for ordinary people, we will add a few more. Natural numbers, in particular positive numbers. Because of if we would have infinitely many solutions, then these numbers would get arbitrarily large. And p is a fixed number, so we would get on the right side numbers which are larger than p.